In today's video, I have prepared for you an example of mobile app design screens prepared by novice UX and UI designer with the intention of improving them. Watching experienced designers reworking designs and providing feedback behind their decisions is one of the best ways of developing your own skills faster. As you can see, we have three screens from an online store mobile app, representing different stages of shopping experience. Let's start with the home screen. There is one thing about it that stands out right away. Now, let me show you this screen after my alterations and see if you can spot the changes. The obvious one is definitely the background. I don't know if it was a software error or a designer's conscious decision, but this shade of gray doesn't really work well, especially with the secondary color. Lighter tone provides better contrast and visibility of the content that matters. In this case, product cards and navigational elements. Next big thing is the navigation. I assume that the intention here was to introduce some sort of animation. But you need to remember that although the icons representing different views are relatively straightforward in this case, in more complex apps that may not be the case. That's why the addition of dedicated labels will provide better guidance to potential users. From the design's resolution, I deduce that they were intended for the latest versions of iPhone and iOS. A good idea for any of you designing stuff for a particular platform is to reach out and to see the design guidelines for them and to follow them. It's also a good idea to include some of its system UI elements. Not only will it look more believable, but also allow you to spot any issues with size and distance between elements. Next change is around product cards. As you can see, I removed unnecessary elements, which doesn't really do much, but at the same time, they are introducing a lot of information noise to the design. I also changed their color to white. Reason behind this is mostly a pragmatic one. Most of the product photographs are done on the white background. That means it will save a lot of time for anyone uploading products to the store in the future, because they won't have to adjust photographs to match the style of the app. Speaking of photos, as you can see, I replaced them with more professional looking ones. In designs where we are dealing with a lot of them, their quality is a key because they are affecting overall perception. Nice photos or illustrations will always elevate any design. As you can hear, I'm not a native speaker, but whenever you deal with any language, try to make sure that everything is written properly. Otherwise, your work will look sloppy. On the original design, we have two different font types. Typically, that's okay, but here it introduces unnecessary complications and doesn't really provide much value. Through utilization of just one font, we are reducing visual noise, introducing consistency, and the app itself will be easier to implement. Last thing is the size of the font. Remember that ultimately your designs will be displayed on their respectable devices. So make sure that things like text buttons are accessible by their users. Okay, it's time for the new screen. Much of the things I mentioned before will carry over to this one. Again, I will give you a moment to spot the differences. Also, try to recall the reason behind the changes. As you can see, I'm following the style I introduced on the previous screen. That means background and cards color, as well as removal of unnecessary elements. There's no need for dedicated buttons which would add a product to a shop cart, at least not in the context of this shop. It could work for something like groceries, but how often have you bought a pricey product like laptop from a category page in the past? I'm also following with updated photos of products and updates to copy. Last thing is introduction of previously mentioned iOS UI elements and addition of gradient mask to hint scrolling behavior and contents below the fold. Let us move to the final screen. Try to figure out the changes. The biggest issue with this screen is the background behind the product. You can imagine that blue isn't universal for different cases and doesn't support presentation well. The logic here is the same as for product cards. White is better for product presentation and typical product photographs. Next is the change around product score. It's a nice idea to provide the reviews to potential customers, but without a scale, the number itself doesn't provide much information. By providing additional context of scale for the grade, we are doing a much better job in providing that information to a user. We can't forget about navigational elements within our app designs. In this example, there is no way for a user to go back. Of course, in most of the cases, we can go back through the right gesture, but not all users are using them. The last change is around the action balance. This may be a little controversial and would require validation with the users, but I think that logically it would be better to have just one button which would add a product to a card. My first argument is that it would promote further browsing of the shop offer. Second, based on my experience, people tend to add products that they are interested in to the card, compare them, and then remove the unwanted ones before proceeding with the purchase. Let me know in the comments if you agree with that. Also, if you would like for me to redesign and comment on your designs, please reach out to me. If you are scared or you have issues with receiving critique, please watch this video next, because it will help you to deal with it better.